Today, I got 5 questions every blockchain developer should know. Some are super easy, some are quite hard, but none of them should feel unfamiliar to you. You might learn something. Comment below if you got them all right or which ones are new to you. And don't cheat. First one. What is MetaMask exactly used for? A. It's a browser plugin that generates and stores private keys. B. It's a browser plugin that must interact with Infura to sign transactions. C. It's a browser plugin that connects to Infura to show your account balance. MetaMask from MetaMask.io is a browser plugin. It makes interaction with the blockchain extremely easy, and it can sign transactions with a private key, no matter on which network or blockchain node you are connected to. That means it does not have to connect to Infura. It can connect with any blockchain via RPC. Answer B is out of the way. To sign transactions, you need a private key from somewhere. And in essence, yes, it generates and stores private keys. So A is the correct answer. Before MetaMask was invented, onboarding to Ethereum was pretty time consuming. Getting access to an Ethereum client via a RESTful API isn't always so straightforward and fundamentally changed the way users start interacting with the blockchain today. The earliest commit of MetaMask was 2015. It's extremely well maintained and active, and I can recommend it. Competitors in terms of ease of use might be Fortmatic or Portis.io. Next question. Which is the right order for denominations on the Ethereum blockchain? A. Gwei, Finney, Szabo, Ether, Tether. B. Finney, Szabo, Mega Ether, Mether, Gwei. Or C. Gwei, Szabo, Finney, Ether. Did you think A? I always think A, because Ether is before, you know, Tether. But let's see. Like Bitcoin, Ether is not the smallest unit on the Ethereum blockchain. The smallest unit is Gwei, followed by Gwei, Mega Gwei or Mgwei, Gwei, Szabo, Finney, and Ether. So the correct answer is C. My favorite tool to get a great overview isn't so much the Ethereum documentation on that. It's more the Ether converter, which I found a fun tool to play around with. Next one. What is the nonce field used for in a transaction? A. It's a numerical field to protect against replay attacks. B. It's a checksum of the hash of the previous block to verify the transaction order. C. It's a sum of all ether sent from this specific address. In general, a nonce is usually a number that can only be used once. In this case, it's specifically against replay attacks, so the answer A is the correct answer. Every time you send a transaction from an account on Ethereum, the nonce is increased, starting at zero. You can't skip any number. And since the network is public and every node has access to the same information, it's obviously easy to check that neither a number was used twice or a number was skipped. Next question. In Solidity, if you divide the integer -5 by the integer 2, the result is A. -2 because decimals are truncated or rounded to 0. B. It's -3 because it's always rounded correctly. Or C. It's -2.5 because it's automatically converted or casted into a float. D. It's not possible since Solidity only knows unsigned integers. The answer, I couldn't say it any better than the Solidity documentation itself. Since the type of the result of an operation is always the type of one of the operands, division on integers always results in an integer. In Solidity, division rounds towards zero, which means it's truncating. That means that an integer -5 divided by an integer of 2 is an integer of -2. In this case, so it would be -2. So A is the correct answer. Did you get this right? Ethereum addresses versus public keys versus private keys. Which answer is correct? An address is 20 bytes long, a public key is 64 bytes, and the private key is 32 bytes long. B. An address is 20 characters long, a public key is 32 characters long, and a private key is 64 characters long, hex characters. C. There is no public key, the public key is the address, both are 20 bytes, the private key is 32 bytes long. To answer this, let's have a look at the Ethereum Yellow Paper. In Appendix F, signing transactions of the Ethereum Yellow Paper, we can follow along how addresses are generated. First, it's assumed that a sender has a private key which is 32 bytes long. That means answer B is already incorrect, since we're talking about bytes, not characters. Leaves A or C. Furthermore, if we run the ECDSA pub key, we get a 64 bytes long key. It's also called a public key, which means answer A is correct. Now, the address are the rightmost 160 bits of the KSAC hash of the public key. In other words, the last 40 hex characters of the hash, or the right 20 bytes. Since 1 byte is 8 bits, 160 bits are 20 bytes, but that's another story. How many did you get right? Comment below. I hope you liked this video, subscribe to this channel, and I hope I will see you in one of the next videos.